Hello everybody and welcome back to another Let's Build a City video. That's right, we're back inside New Blockton City. We're joined with a few helpers this time. And I'll introduce you to my build team. That's right, this is the people that have made it in to the RK7 build team. And that's the thing we were kind of hosting the other day, accepting invites and stuff into. So we'll just go through them. We've got Mining Dwarf, otherwise known as Dwarf. We've got Sweet, otherwise known as Matthew Reindeer. Tonic Strobe. We've got AJ here. Liam, I'm sure you know Liam. And I'm sure you know Ryan as well. And we also have Terry, the Terrible Dragon. And yeah, so welcome people. Welcome to the build team. And what we're going to do, we're going to do a Mexican wave. We practiced this a second beforehand. So here we go. Ready for the build team, Mexican wave. One, two, three. Let's go. Mexican wave. Oh, okay. Well, that went well. I'm surprised it went well. Anyway, let's get rid of this. Today, we are building a kind of a shopping center type thing, but not a mini shopping center, but just a scaled down version. As you can see, we've done this plan above, and you can get to work, by the way, guys. Whilst I give this little brief overview, we've done a basic plan, and so what we're going to do is, as you can see, there's this one main rectangle. This is going to be the walkway where there's like benches, a couple of little plants and stuff, and then these squares off the side are where the shops are going to be, and at the back here, you know, you usually have like food courts and stuff. That is what these are going to be. There's going to be a seating area here, and then two little restaurants with kitchens at the back to hopefully make a nice little food court area. But it's quite a modern design, so we've got a basic little design planned beforehand, and this is how it's turning out so far. So it's good that we are making progress, and I think I will help out and make a little start on that, and let's see. We haven't planned it really apart from these pillars, so we'll just have to see how it goes, really. It's the first time building with the build team properly. We did some test runs, but not everyone was there. So, let's see. I'm going to try and prevent it from just being plain white. So I'm going to add in probably a layer of kind of clay, and I'll show you how I'm going to do that in just a second. So if I just build this up, have a little border going, and if someone repeats this on the other side, that would be super handy as well. And there you go. Yeah, we planned this kind of wooden part going across as well. We'll do the wooden part. In fact, do the wooden part, Tonic. If you do it up above here, we'll build the pillars higher. But, that's it. That's good. You just build that going across, right? So we've got our little square for detail to add in here. In fact, what I'm going to do, prevent that being 2D, I'm going to bring this back one. This whole design is going to go back one, so to about here, and I probably should sort that out on this side as well before things get too confusing. Right, hopefully we'll make quite a decent bit of progress, because we got all these people in the game. Our lucky winners, well, not so much lucky, our talented winners of build team places, and it's looking pretty nice so far, guys, so keep it up. Right, so we've got this as our basic area for the thing. So if we just have about like a strip of this, just to add in like a differentiation of color, and then let's see, we'll probably want to add in, well, we probably don't want to add in glass at the front, but we still want it to be quite well detailed and like look quite appealing. So let's just do this on that side as well to keep it symmetrical like this. So I might do some designs with stairs, but I did say like I don't want it to look too like detailed, because modern designs look quite basic, like bold structures. And things like that. Right, I think what we'll do is have the logo design for the shopping mall here. So if I just make a little box where I'm going to make the logo, I'm going to probably make it about this size. So just work around this, people. Right, so if we do that, we can probably just use these colours and that'll be fine. Let's go with this and this. I know this looks similar to the other design I had. You do that and then have something pretty cool like this. No, that looks pretty bad. See, what other blocks could we use? We could use white. Kind of looks like an eye. That looks pretty cool for a shopping mall logo. And let's just make this a little bit more rounded as well by putting stairs here. And what's this say? Uncentered. Oh, it's uncentered. Yeah. If someone could... Wait, hang on. 1, 2, 3, 4, that side. Oh, 1, 2, 3. Okay. What we'll do then is simply just bring this round like that. Bring this one. Wait, we'll need these blocks. So that comes there. This is why I've got my good build team, people. Right, there you go. That's centered. That looks pretty cool, if you ask me. Right. Like that. Bring this round. And we wanted kind of a half glass roof, so it's going to have like a quartz border, and then the roof's going to be quite quartzy, I suppose. So that's looking quite nice. And we just want to fill in these two mainly, because that's the main front walls. So if we just go and do probably a plain background, then add some design on. In fact, what I'm going to do... I'm going to take some design from this mini supermarket, because that was quite a nice modern design I did. Okay, so this had windows on the front. It still had loads of different stripes and colours throughout, so I just took a little bit of inspiration from that. Hopefully that will help with this design, but it's quite big as well, so you might want to, if you're recreating stuff like this, get your friends in on it as well. Obviously it's more fun to build with friends. Anyway, right, so let's just do... some pillars of some sort. So if we just go, let's build up cobblestone. I know it's like not modern at all, but it's handy. Oh, and actually that's pointing out something. By putting that stone there, might need to add in, no, that's fine actually. Right, what I'll do is I'll go like this. Hopefully this will link up and be equal to what I want. Okay, so that's good. And let's just put in pillars of, probably let's just try pillars of stone. Yes, AJ, that looks sick, my friend. If I went like this, or is that not linking up? That needs to get removed, I think. Like that. Well, I need to work this out. Let's just build up these pillars, then I'll work it out. And oops, that's not what I want. Change these around so it's easy access. So I want these pillars going up. And I might change the design and stuff, people, so if it doesn't look great on the first attempt, which it quite often doesn't, then I will have it altered until it looks decent. Right. You know, that's actually not too bad. Right, if we just fill in this with green, I think that's the right green. Oh, no, it's not. Where's the right one? There. So we'll go like that. And then... let's see. Yeah, Ryan, we don't want it too like detailed. It looks kind of like a big radiator at the moment. But I think it looks okay, to be honest. I might add in some just kind of... Oh, wait. No, that gives me an idea. Why did I not think about this? Right, get rid of all these pillars. Second, what I just did in the live stream is such a good idea for a wall filler. I was saying in the live stream how if you've got like a modern wall and you need it filled in just with any design, just use this, people. Just go, actually we'll go from the size, it kind of looks like a wing actually. Fill that in. Want to go about here, just keep going up. And although it's simple, it looks pretty cool. And of course, it's modern, which is what we want. And I don't know what's going on there. Let's just keep this going, Liam. I don't know what you're doing, but let's keep with this design. So let's get rid of those as well. And oops, we fix that design. Goes to there. That one comes to there. That one comes to here. All right. That looks pretty odd. I don't know. Right. I'll leave that to you guys to sort out. I'm gonna work on something else because I'm gonna let more creative minds sort it out. Let's just put a little border around this as well, just so it's, so you can see more of a clear definition between the glass and the other stuff. Right, this is turning out pretty cool though. We made a good bit of progress, and it looks like the glass roof is coming along quite nicely too. Alright, that's okay. And what's that say? Bale board. I don't know what a bale board is, but there you go. Right. Yeah, that's actually on the wrong way. Still does kind of look cool. Not gonna lie. But yeah, try swap that over so it's coming out either side, if you know what I mean. Not sure if you get what I mean there, but. Both the sides, what's that say? Build board. I think he means billboard, but no, we can't have a billboard there because no one will be able to reach it. Right, okay, let's see, let's make some progress on the center here. So let's do a basic shop design. We want it to look really good and modern. So if we do between every one, we just go like this, keep our pillar designs, and oops, not that, get rid of that. Have this going up because this is what we use on the outside. So it's then like repeating the same design. It looks like the shopping mall's color scheme, stuff like that. So if you just have the pillars up there between each one, that should look pretty good. In fact, get rid of that one there. We can have another one like that. And we can fit all the shops in between this. So say this shop's a clothes store. We could build up to about here, I'd say, and then go with the wood again. So where's something like this? We can go like build this straight across, and this is where the logo for the shops or the writing for the shops can go. And yeah, should turn out pretty nicely. Anyway, we're doing well for time as well, people. We're 13 minutes. So yeah, take that as a basic shop design. Let's just build up some glass entrance ways as well. So center about there like this, that's fine. We want to fill these in. I'm going to check out the front as well, people. You can add in your designs and stuff. Let's just get this done. That's our basic shop front. Obviously you can do whatever you feel looks best for a shop when you're building this in your own world. But I think this looks quite nice. The basic shop design. And yeah, we can just put some doors. I always think these doors look quite good because it almost looks like they'd be filled in with glass where the gaps are. And that is not right. Hold on. How do I get this? There we go. So that's the basic design for the shop. There can be different colours and stuff for shops as well. Yeah, like different coloured glass. Yeah, let's check this out. Okay, so that turned out okay. What I might do is I might just get rid of like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then just have it just changed up the design a bit. Let's do it on this side as well. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3. And then just get rid of that corner bit there. Might just look a little better. Yeah, I like that, you see. I think that looks pretty cool. We can have like a little design in the corner here. I'm not sure what, but we can have some kind of design, I suppose. I guess we can incorporate this more. If we just did like patterns like this, maybe? Wait. Like that, and that in the middle. Just something simple that we can add in and it actually look like a bit of detailed artwork or logo or stuff like that. So let's try that again on this side. I think it was, actually I don't want to be guessing again because the last time I guessed it I got it wrong. So it went like that. Oh wait, no, it went like that. I think it was one away from the edge. Yeah, one away from the edge. And then this gets put up like so. Okay, people, this is looking good. I'm going to fix the top here. This is a little bit of spruce gone a bit weird. Oh, that's not spruce. It's this. Let's just build it a bit flatter here. And on this side, there you go. It's nice. It's like a big, bold kind of separation off from the rest of the design. Right, I'm liking the look of this, people. Then I think actually quite a few shopping centers have these kind of overhangs where, like, if you're waiting for a taxi or getting dropped off or getting your shopping carts, then you can stand underneath it. So we did like that. That should be fine. Hopefully this will look okay. Actually, let's just build the front bit and see what it looks like from a little distance, because I don't want to be filling it all in if it doesn't look that great. Yeah, that should be fine. In fact, wait, hold on. If we just leave a gap and fill it in with glass, that adds that modern thing again with it. So if we just go like this, so I think that's what they have in supermarkets as well. And also, Ryan, I think you built that little tree out the front. It'd be cool if we had another one on the other side as well. Right, yeah, I'm liking the look of this shopping centre. It is looking like a shopping centre. Right, so there we go. And we should probably do this in two episodes, like completely finish it. Because when I've got, wait, how many people is there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Plus me, that's 7. When there's 7 people all focused on one build, it's so good, because we can actually get like bigger structures done. Which, and sorry, I knocked the microphone there, but that also means we'll have time for skyscrapers and bigger projects, because a lot of the postponing of that was down to, you know, having these 25-minute slots in which I have to fill with content. And not being able to get something massive done in that time, because we struggled with these big buildings, getting them done in 25 minutes. So we just did one front. But here, in 18 minutes and 30 seconds, we've got a pretty awesome modern looking, what's it, shopping mall. Well, that's pretty cool. We've got a toy store going on. We've got, not sure what this is. Oh, I think that's the clothes store. We've got AJ's building. Not sure what's turning into it. As long as it's not a cafe. So if it's a cafe, there's no point of having the food court. And Ryan's working on the food court. So good job, my friend. We've got a Subway going on here. Yeah, that's nice. What even is the Subway logo? It's like yellow and green, I think. So you just keep the yellow theme in there as well. Right, I'm not sure what I should do for an entranceway. Whether I should have kind of this design. I'll just show you now. So we want probably coming out to about here. So you'll probably want doorways. I was thinking about leaving it open, but you don't really see that in shopping centres. You usually see like big glass entranceways with revolving doors and stuff. Obviously, revolving doors, not really possible in this, which are working anyway. So if we just did some alternatives and just did, well, normal doors, that would probably make him turn out like, hang on, if we did that, right, we'll do double doors, so like that and that, that's fine. And then we can just have another set on this side, right? And we'll fill this in with, wait, what are we going for the color scheme again? Oh, we want gray and this blue. So we got the blue, light gray. We can just go like this. kind of checkered up. I mean, you probably can't see it that well, but I guess you know it's there, and it's more interesting than just plain glass. So let's just bring this across like so. Okay, right, we'll check up on how the subway and all that's going in just a sec. Right, it's very difficult to actually see the colour here, so we just keep alternating it, it should all line up by itself. Okay, right, and then this, that's grey, needs to be like that. And this needs to be grey, needs to be like that, that needs to be blue, and that needs to be grey. That should be the front doors sorted out. Okay, that looks pretty good actually, people. I'm liking the look of that. What we'll do, I think, is have it another kind of layer. Just add that bold kind of thing to it. We can just have that as a little bit of stuff to break up the blockiness. Okay, so that's fine. Then we'll add in a design by going... In fact, we can do quite a good design I'm fond of. It's just going like this. Go in like that. Just to break up again any boring or blocky designs too much. Because obviously we want it to be blocky to a certain extent to make it with a modern theme. But we don't want it to be boring. So we go like that. That's fine. I don't know what that is. Oh, there's always that one balloon which is left up at the top of shopping malls. That's so true. Whoever added that, that is like the best idea ever. Right, that looks pretty cool. It's like a kind of a Illuminati shopping mall here. Yeah, hang on, let me get rid of this. I'm gonna change it and set it back one, or else it looks a little bit too much. So say we have our glass going along here. Yeah, that's where it'll go. So we want to go just build all this across. So if someone could help me quickly with the glass here, that would be pretty handy. Just so I can get on and do the design right. Thank you, Tonic, my friend. See, it's so handy having all these builders. Sure, you guys will enjoy some of the builds we come up with. Anyway, we're running low, people, on time. So get your skates on. Let's see what we can do in the last... a couple of minutes of the build. Right, that looks quite nice actually. If I just did this, let's try and make it look less Illuminati-ish this time. Build this coming up to the top here. Just for a bit of detail, a bit more of an intricate design, I suppose. Yep, that's fine. And from the top here, let's build this going down. Okay. I'm pretty pleased with how this has turned out, actually. So well done, guys. Yeah, this has been a very good project. And what's a balloon say? Balloon. Oh, okay. But yeah, I could definitely tell it was a balloon. That's always true. Every, like, shopping centre has got it where some kids let go of their McDonald's balloon. It's just floated to the top and stays there for, like, years. But how good does this look? It does look like a decent shopping mall. Obviously, we've got to put the roof on. We've got the basic glass thing. This will just be white border around the edge. And then stone filled in the middle. And then, like, a bunch of ventilation. The walls, again, probably just plain quartz. A set back one like this. Oops, sorry. And we might, like, put a couple of lines and stuff on. Like, as you can see with this... We just filled in walls by doing basic lines and stuff. So, yeah, it's only really the front you need to worry about getting detailed if you want it to look like this one. But, yeah, people, that's brought us to the end of the video. So, thank you, everyone in the build team, for helping out. If you want to say goodbyes to the video, then come out to the front now. But thank you, everybody, for watching. We appreciate it. And look at the progress we've made. So yeah, hopefully we'll see you in the next video.